is up there. Clint Johnston Porter replacing Alan Kennedy, not riding here this afternoon. Gifted Warrior, the last of them loaded, goes in. The field is set. 1600 the journey. Racing as well. Depara first to land out of the gates. From the inside, though, Cube and Twist is going to burn through and take control of the lead early, and coming over, Sweet Angeline along with Eurasia. Now, Piccola Senora's up much more handier than expected. She's better than midfield in front of Magic Will Reign, then Carrageenan Aurora, Gifted Warrior. The favourite back there is third from last, Sentimental Queen, as they steady them up. Over on the inside to Pretty Friar, and back there at the tail is Sluice Box. 11:50 left to go, and Cube and Twist first up from a spill, leads the way for Jade McNaught with 1,000 to run, a half a length on Eurasia, who tugged his way up there. Now sits at the girth of the pacemaker. This gives Sweet Angeline the drop on those with the run of the race, third in the clear. A length and a half back on the outside, Magic Will Reign, just shading the little filly Piccola Senora. In the middle then came Depara, Sentimental Queen, covering a bit of ground there, three deep in the red silks. Over on the inside, Gifted Warrior, back in the field, Sluice Box is starting to take off around Carrageenan Aurora, and Pretty Friar is back last of all as they headed past the 500. They're nearing the home turn, and it's Cube and Twist who'll bring them for the judge over Eurasia, Sweet Angeline, and then came Magic Will Reign, who's travelled up there in fourth placing. Now the favourite starts to stride up to them quickly. Here comes Sentimental Queen at the top of the home straight, running on very strongly, and Sluice Box is further back at the 200. Eurasia tackled and headed by Sentimental Queen. Sentimental Queen races to the lead. Sluice Box on the outside, trying hard with Eurasia. Sentimental Queen in front. Sluice Box comes late. Sentimental Queen's too good. Sentimental Queen beats Sluice Box. Eurasia third. Cuban Twist ran fourth from Piccola Senora. And then from last, Pretty Friar from Gifted Warwick, Carrageenan Aurora, Sweet Angeline, Magic Will Reign. And tailing them home is Depara. Sentimental Queen, Lucy Warwick, the favourite. Too good, and she goes back to back from as many runs now here for the Ballantyne Yard, the daughter of Alma Herr, and has put them away impressively. Three deep worked around them, put right into the race here at the top of the stretch by Warwick, Sentimental Queen, gobbled up Eurasia, Cube and Twist, Loose Box finishing resolutely after being right back there in the field. Strong performance, and third, number six, Eurasia. 5-8-6. 5-8-6-4, Cuban Twist. Solid run as well, first up over the 1600, but all honours with Sentimental Queen. Owned by Mrs. A. Ballantyne R. Hennessy, the Beers and Banter Syndicate, along with J. Phoebe, the Turtle Tote Syndicate, NPC Syndicate, T.J. Rodder, S. Artemis, P. Hughes, and C. Norris, ridden by Lucy Warwick for Hayden Ballantyne. Sentimental Queen wins 5 from 14, 2 for 2 here for the new yard. Sluice Box second by My Admiration from Ready in Waiting, Ash Maley, Clint Johnston Porter. Third, Eurasia by Eurozone out of Bengal Angel, Steve Wolf, Sean McGruddy. Fourth, Money to Four, Cuban Twist. 140.61 was the time. 36.91, the overall 600 and 3/4 by 3/4 official margins. Race 9, the Conquer Cystic Fibrosis Handicap over the 1500 to round out the day at 5 o'clock. Number 8, Playing Marika. The scratching there, 12 to run in the last on the card. Brittany Taylor is about to join us down here in the enclosure after this victory of Sentimental Queen, prepared by former Frio Dockers ace. Now turned trainer, doing a really good job too with his team, Hayden Ballantyne. Sentimental Queen looks as though she's set to win a lot more races too after that performance today. As Hayden joins us now, he's just broken a tag down there. Britton, you've got him under control after the victory.
Yeah, there's plenty of taggers in here, all in red caps as well. Hayden, they weren't able to be here last start with all the lockdown restrictions, essential personnel, but they're out in force today.
Yeah, now the boys are a bit flat. They couldn't get here last week, but she produced again today and got the win for the boys, and they're stoked, and they love the red hats. It's become a bit of a cult thing, so it's really good.
It looks fantastic. We could hear them cheering her home. Now, when we spoke after our first up win, you were really pleased with just how she'd returned this preparation. She really justified that today.
Yeah, she's gone even better at track work during the week. she's a bit of a maniac, but I love her. She's really, really good to have around the stable. She's got a bit of character to her, and yeah, love having her around. And Lucy rode her a treat. I said just keep her wide, keep her out of trouble, and she'll do the rest. And yeah, Lucy did a great job.
What were you thinking during the run? Were you full of confidence, knowing that she obviously has the staying pedigree on her side to sort of endure a bit of a run home?
If you try and hold her up, she loses the plot a little bit. So just let her roll like Lucy did. She's only ridden her a few times. She knows the horse really well. So yeah, great ride. And yeah, she produced at the end, which is what we wanted.
Do you think she can just keep on her winning ways, especially with Belmont in our sights?
I hope so. And obviously she gets over ground a lot better. So, yeah, she's a little bit untapped in what she can do. And, yeah, we'll just keep on riding the wave with her and see how good she can be.
Well, congratulations on not just today's win, but back-to-back victories with her. Well done.
Thanks, Britt.
There's Hayden Ballantyne. Brilliant win. Another one for Sentimental Queen. And we're saying it time and time again, but doing a wonderful job with these tried horses. And the Beers and Banter Syndicate as well. It's a lot of fun. You can just see everyone comes out to the races with the red caps on, and they were disappointed they couldn't be here last start, but they've made up for it today, and I'm sure they'll be celebrating well into the night. And why shouldn't they? Because they have a lovely mare who I think they're going to have a lot of fun with, Scott.
Exactly right. Over the winter, Britt, they should have a lot of fun with this mare. She should, in theory, being out of one of Bob and Sandra Peters' mares, only get better and better as they step her out over further. And obviously, I've heard Hayden Ballantyne mention after the first up victory that he actually thinks that she might even be able to improve on a wet track. So that would be something more again, Britt. I think Lucy Warwick might be getting a couple of selfies here, so we might not be able to get her, but I think we'll be talking to her a lot over the winter with Sentimental Queen, because she looks like she can go right through the grades, and we know that those winter staying ranks do thin out.
Yeah, they're on the selfie train, that is right. One more to come here from Ascot, but right now, Sky Thoroughbred Central, it's off to Sha Tin.
Trying to get you high, fade it off this touch. You don't need a long.